This is Rebecca from chemistryismyjam.com. In this video, we're going to learn to draw Bohr models. In the last video, we learned that the Bohr model of the atom was sometimes called the planetary model because it had electrons going around the nucleus very much like planets go around the sun. We now know that there are some issues with that model of the atom. It's not totally accurate in terms of what's actually going on inside the atom. However, it still helps us make some valuable statements about the atom. It still helps us picture the fact that the electrons are located within energy levels in the atom. And the energy levels that are closest to the nucleus have lower energy. One thing that you should be aware of as you learn to draw Bohr models is that the number of electrons that each energy level holds follows a certain formula. The formula is 2n squared, where n is the energy level. For example, the first energy level, if you take a 1 and plug it in for n, 1 squared is 1 times 2 gives you 2 electrons. So the first energy level can hold up to 2 electrons. This formula has helped me figure out how many electrons the first energy level can hold. For the second energy level, plug a 2 in for n, 2 squared is 4, times 2 gives me 8. The second energy level can hold up to 8 electrons. For the third energy level, 3 squared is 9, times 2 is 18. The third energy level can hold up to 18 electrons. So it doesn't have to have 18 electrons, but it can't have more than 18. It is full with 18 electrons. Let's look at some examples where we're going to draw the Bohr models for carbon, sulfur, nitrogen, and magnesium. We need to keep those number of electrons that each energy level can hold in mind as we do this. So you want to keep in mind that the first energy level can hold 2, the second energy level can hold 8, and the third energy level can hold 18 electrons. You also want to pay attention to the fact that for a neutral atom, the number of electrons will match the atomic number. So our first example is going to be carbon. Carbon has 6 protons because it's element number 6 on the periodic table. So we're going to be drawing 6 electrons for a neutral atom of carbon. The first thing you want to do is somehow indicate where the nucleus is. For this, some people put a dot. I tend to use the symbol for the element. So for carbon, I'm going to put a C in the center. That's representing my nucleus, but it's also letting me know that this is the Bohr model for carbon. Next, I need to draw circles to represent energy levels. So I'm going to start with one circle. It's going to be fairly close to the nucleus. That is the first energy level, and we know that the first energy level can hold up to 2 electrons. Keep in mind, this is carbon. I'm going to be drawing a total of 6 electrons. 2 of those can go in the first energy level. So I'm going to add 2 electrons. I'm going to use dots to represent those electrons. You can see that I've put my 2 dots far away from one another. They are both representing electrons. Both of those electrons have a negative charge. Since they have the same charge, they're going to repel one another. So I've put them far away from one another to try to indicate that. At this point, I have used 2 of carbon's 6 electrons. There's 4 more electrons that I need to draw. I have filled up my first energy level. The remaining 4 can all fit into my second energy level. So I need to draw a second energy level. I'm going to put a circle outside of my first circle. It gets 4 electrons, and once again, I'm going to spread those 4 electrons out. So now I have drawn the 6 electrons that make up carbon. 2 of those electrons are in the first energy level. At that point, that energy level is full. The remaining ones all fit into the second energy level. Now, even though we know that in the true atom, electrons are not moving in perfect little orbits around the nucleus, this is still a useful model of the atom because it helps me picture the energy levels where those electrons are located. The things that you need to keep in mind as you draw these: your number of electrons will match your protons as long as you're doing a neutral atom. The first energy level holds 2, the second holds 8, and the third holds 18. Let's move on to our next example, which is sulfur. Sulfur is element number 16 on the periodic table, so it has 16 protons. A neutral atom of sulfur will also have 16 electrons. I'm going to use the symbol of sulfur to represent my nucleus, and I want to start drawing in energy levels. Here's my first energy level. My first energy level will be full with 2 electrons. So I've drawn my 2 electrons. At this point, that energy level is full. I've used 2 of my 16 electrons. There are 14 more electrons that need to be drawn. 8 of those can go in the second energy level. So I'm going to go ahead and draw my second energy level. At this point, I'm going to fill up that energy level. So I want to point out something that's very common when people draw Bohr models. There's 4 locations in an energy level where they tend to put electrons. They tend to use these 4 corners right here, and they put the electrons in pairs. So I'm going to be putting pairs of electrons. I do want to spread them out as much as possible, but they tend to go in pairs. So I'm going to have one here, one here, one here, and one here, and then I would start to pair them in that same location. The most crucial thing is to make sure that you have the correct number of electrons on the correct energy level, but this is the accepted way for drawing Bohr models, to put them in pairs, but to spread them out. So let's take a step back and see what we've drawn so far. We've put 2 electrons on the first energy level and 8 electrons on the second energy level. So we have drawn 10 electrons. There's a total of 16. We need to draw 6 more electrons. So I'm going to draw a third energy level here. This third energy level can hold up to 18. However, we only need to use 6. All right, so I'm going to have 6 electrons on this energy level. I still want to spread them out, so I'm putting the first 4 spread out, and then there's 2 remaining that will end up getting paired. So there's 6 electrons on the third energy level. And now we are done with the Bohr model for sulfur. Let's go give nitrogen a try. Nitrogen is element number 7 on the periodic table, so it has 7 protons. And since it's neutral nitrogen, we know that it has 7 electrons. I use the symbol for nitrogen as my nucleus. My first energy level can hold 2 of those 7 electrons, meaning that there are 5 more that are going to go in this outside energy level. And I'm going to kind of go to my 4 corners, and then one of them's going to have to get paired. So the Bohr model for nitrogen has 2 electrons in the first energy level and 5 electrons in the second energy level. Let's take a look at magnesium. Magnesium is element 12 on the periodic table, so I'll be drawing 12 electrons. I'm going to use the symbol for magnesium in the center. My first energy level can hold 2 of my electrons. At that point, my first energy level is full. My second energy level can hold up to 8. I'm going to need to fill that energy level up as well. Okay, so I'm putting 8 electrons. I'm spreading them out, but I'm putting them in pairs. So I've drawn a total of 10 electrons. I'm going to end up with 2 more electrons in this outside energy level, and I want to spread those out. And that is the Bohr model for magnesium. That wraps up how we draw Bohr models. Stick around as we learn about the electromagnetic spectrum and how electrons relate to light being given off.